Capernaum was a fishing village located on the northern shore of the Sea of Galilee. After Jesus finished speaking to the people, he entered the village. A Roman centurion in the village had a servant he prized highly. This servant was on his deathbed, and he didn't want to lose him. So when the centurion heard Jesus was back, he sent leaders from the Jewish community to ask him to come and heal his servant. The Jewish leaders went to Jesus and urged him to help, saying, "He deserves this. He loves our people. He even built a synagogue." Even though Luke is a man of detail, the Roman centurion is never named. Luke focuses on the character of the man, his position and power, rather than his identity. Luke wants his readers to think of this man as a Gentile in power. The centurion was a military officer attached to the occupying force in Israel. His power with respect to Jewish citizens was almost unlimited. The centurion had an exalted view of Jesus Christ and his authority over this helpless disease. He knew that his servant's condition was desperate and beyond the realm of his authority. The centurion valued the sick servant so much that he was willing to send Jewish elders to intercede for him and convince Jesus to come and save his servant. Our Savior went to help out of mercy. Remember, the centurion had unlimited authority over the Jewish citizenry. Jesus is a man subject to the centurion's political authority, but the centurion does not send soldiers to order Jesus to help him, but he sends Jewish leaders hoping that they can persuade Jesus to heal his servant. Now, Jewish elders interceded because they felt the centurion worthy of the Lord's mercy, since he had been kind and loving to the Jewish people. And this was generally not expected from Roman authorities. Now let's put this in context. The centurion humbled himself to ask Jesus to physically heal not himself, but someone else, a servant, a young lad in pain who is likely Jewish, and now he is asking a subject of Rome to do him a favor. The centurion is appealing to Jesus out of human need, not because of his power or worthiness or merit. The centurion offers nothing in return for the healing of his servant. When Jesus was a distance from the house, the centurion sent friends to talk to Jesus. The centurion sent a message indicating that he was a man who must follow orders from his superiors, and he gave orders and they must be followed by his soldiers. Now, why did Luke think this important to include? Well, the centurion, like us today, interprets the world through the experiences of his life. The centurion is saying, "I know how the world works." Just as centurions order soldiers and it is done, Jesus only needs to order that the servant be healed, and I know that Jesus has authority over the illness, and my servant will be healed. It is from this worldview that the centurion asserts, "Master, you do not have to go to all the trouble coming to my home." This Roman officer says that he is not worthy of a visit from Jesus to his home, and that he is not even worthy to visit Jesus. But even in his self-declared unworthy state, the centurion believes that Jesus only needs to give the order, and as a superior authority over the illness, he will be obeyed and his servant will get well. As modern Christians, we sometimes are so disappointed in ourselves, we feel unworthy of God's grace. But we know that our Heavenly Father has unconditional love for us. The centurion saw himself as unworthy of God's grace, nor was he even worthy to meet Jesus. But the centurion had faith that Jesus' love was forgiving enough, his authority was great enough, that Jesus only needed to give the order for his servant to be healed. This powerful Roman officer is appealing to Jesus from the perspective of a lower-ranking soldier, and this amazes Jesus, so much so that Jesus addresses the crowd following him, saying, "I have not come across this kind of simple trust anywhere in Israel, the very people who are supposed to know about God and how he works." When the messenger got back home, they found the servant well. We each experience and perceive Jesus through the events of our own lives. We use our lives to interpret the meaning of His word. It is through the filth, the lies, the hope, the disappointment that we perceive Jesus, seeing Him there with arms wide open, beckoning us to come to Him, beckoning us to be healed. That's the lesson for this week. Have a great week. Bye.